My guest right now is number one New York Times and USA Today bestselling author Jennifer L. Armentrout. Her novel, White Hot Kiss, is first in the Dark Elements trilogy and features a very unique group of paranormal beings. The Dark Elements trilogy revolves around these beings that aren't often written about in YA, gargoyles. They're referred to as wardens in the series. Why did you choose to write about this particular type of hero?
One of the main reasons is I am a paranormal girl at heart. And with the paranormal, I think, genre, it's like everything has been kind of written about. So I wanted to write about something that you don't see quite often, especially in young adult fiction, which is the gargoyle. You don't really see about them. We went with the title Wardens because we were afraid that, you know, when you think of gargoyles, you don't think of sexy creatures. They're not very attractive looking in stone.
I've seen a few gargoyles in my time. I was kind of wondering about that.
Yeah, so we went with wardens instead of saying gargoyles all the time. But my beings are definitely 100% gargoyles. They're not what you think they look like. They do have a human form, and then they do shift into a gargoyle form, which is made of stone. And the way they're described, I did take some of the characteristics from the statues that you're, you know, familiar with, but then I added my own little twists to what they do look like when they're in their human form. But, you know, who writes about gargoyles? So I was like, I'll do it.
You've written a variety of genres at this point in your career, from YA, paranormal, adult paranormal, new adult contemporary, contemporary romance, just to name a few. Do you have a favorite genre to write?
Well, the only genre I don't write is historical romance. And it's funny because I love historical romance and I've been reading that, but I can't write it. If I wrote a historical romance, it would be 21st century language and it would just be a hot mess and then some in that. But my favorite genre to write is really paranormal. Like I said, I'm a paranormal girl at heart. That was my go-to books growing up. It's still my go-to book. So that's my favorite because you get to create something that either people are familiar with, but you get to you get to play like an author god and create the creatures. You create your own rules to the world, and you can do whatever you want in that. And you really don't get that ability in contemporary. You have to work in reality completely. But with paranormal, you can do whatever you want. So that's always been my favorite genre.
How do you set about creating a world?
Usually, I start with the characters first. I get an idea what my main characters are going to be like. Then I build off those characters into the world itself. So the world building is something that literally happens as I'm writing. I really have no great plan when I sit down. I just know that, hey, we have gargoyles, yay. Usually that scares editors a little bit when they're like, oh, so what's your world like? Oh, no.
I'll make it up as I go there along.
When I get there. But I start with the characters first and then build the world off of them.
In the Dark Elements trilogy, the teenage heroine, her name is Layla, is torn between two equally appealing guys, Zane, her lifelong crush and warden, and Roth, the sexy bad boy demon prince. He's appeared in her life to tell her that nothing she knows about demons is correct. Mm-hmm. How do you keep the two guys so distinct from each other and while still making Layla and the readers drawn to her?
Well, I think what makes this love triangle unique in a sense is both of the boys are forbidden to Layla. Zane, she pretty much grew up with, and that's been her like lifelong crush. It's who she's idolized, you know, and worshipped as a, you know, younger, you know, around 10 years old and up to her age now. And he kind of keeps her good, keeps, you know, what she is in the good side of things, doesn't let her darkness that she has inside of her come out. But he is forbidden to her. Lila cannot get close to anyone, especially kissing, if she will take their soul. So with Roth, he kind of pops in, and he is also forbidden to her because he is a demon, and he's not your ordinary demon. He is one of the princes. So he is very powerful in the sense, and somebody that she should really stay away from. But he kind of is like, I think of Bridget Jones, like, I just like you the way you are kind of thing, where he accepts her bad side and her good side, but he is also forbidden to her because if she's, you know, it kind of affects her more demonic self that she has in her, that they don't want her around other demons. So I think the fact that both of them are forbidden to her, it makes that, you know, everybody loves a forbidden love story, but them both guys, there's no clear one person that she can be with. You know, everybody has had somebody that they crushed on for years that they, you know, never really showed that kind of interest. And then there's the bad boy. You know, everybody wants the redeemable bad boy. So I think keeping them separate like that, but giving them equal standing, it makes it very difficult for Layla and the reader to see who she wants to be with. I know with the editorial team at Harlequin, it's one day it's Zane, the next day it's Roth, one day it's Zane. So even I have a problem picking which one. So I think the readers will be able to sympathize with Layla that both of them have pros and both of them have cons. So it's not a clear choice.
There's a prequel to the mm-hmm. series called Bittersweet Love.
Yes.
How does that introduce readers to the series?
I'm really excited about Bittersweet Love because the characters that you read about in Bittersweet Love are actually secondary characters in White Hot Kiss and the following books in that series. And it was really interesting writing their background, because when you see them in White Hot Kiss, you know what the status of their relationship is, and then you see how they come together. But it also introduces readers to the world of wardens, where Layla is a totally different character than Jasmine, who is in Bittersweet Love. They're from two different worlds, basically. So you get to see the world building strongly in Bittersweet Love. And Bittersweet Love really is a straight romance. It's a paranormal romance. It's focused on these two characters. And then when you get into White Hot Kiss, you're getting to the actual paranormal aspect of all of it.
What can readers expect from you next?
Well, next is definitely going to be Bittersweet Love, and you'll be introduced to the world. You also will get to see Layla and Zane and Roth in the prequel, so that I'm really excited about that. So that's what's up next.
Well, I wish you all the best
Thank
with
you.
This series, and thanks for sitting down with us
Thank
today.
Thank you.